Everything in the universe is spinning. Spinning planets, and they're spinning moons, orbiting around spinning stars, which orbit spinning galaxies. It's spinning all the way down. Consider that fiery ball in the sky, the sun. Like all stars, our sun rotates on its axis. You can't tell because staring at the sun long enough will permanently damage your eyeballs and you'll go blind. But instead, you can use a special purpose solar telescope to observe sunspots and other features on the surface of the sun. And if you track their movements, you'll see that the sun's equator takes 24.47 days to turn once on its axis, unlike its slower poles, which take 26.24 days to turn. The sun isn't a solid ball of rock. It's a sphere of hot plasma, so the different regions can complete their rotation at different rates. But it rotates so slowly that it's an almost perfect sphere. If you're standing on the surface of the sun, which you can, of course, you would be whipping around at 7,000 kilometers per hour. That sounds fast, but just you wait. How does that compare to other stars? And what's the fastest that a star can spin? A much faster spinning star is Achenar, the 10th brightest star in the sky, located 139 light years away in the constellation of Eridanus. It has about 7 times the mass of the sun, but it spins once on its axis every 2 days. If you could see Achenar up close, it would look like a flattened ball. If you measured it from pole to pole, it would be 7.6 suns across. But if you measured it across the equator, it would be 11.6 suns across. And if you were standing on the surface of Achenar, you'd be hurtling through space at 900,000 kilometers per hour. Now, the very fastest spinning star that we know of is the 25 solar mass VFTS-102, located about 160,000 light years away in the Large Magellanic Clouds Tarantula Nebula, a factory for massive stars. If you were standing on the surface of VFTS-102, you'd be moving at 2 million kilometers per hour. In fact, VFTS-102 is spinning so quickly, it can just barely keep itself together. Any faster, and the outward centripetal force would overcome the gravity holding its guts in, and it would tear itself apart. And perhaps that's why we don't see any spinning faster, because they couldn't handle the speed. It appears that this is the fastest that stars can spin. One other interesting note about VFTS-102 is that it's also hurtling through space much faster than the stars around it. Astronomers think that it was once in a binary system with a partner that detonated as a supernova, releasing it into space like a catapult. Now, not only stars can spin, dead stars can spin too. And they take this to a whole other level. Neutron stars are what you get when a star with much more mass than the sun detonates as a supernova. Suddenly you've got a stellar remnant with twice the mass of the sun compressed down into a tiny ball about 20 kilometers across. All that angular momentum of the star is retained, and so the neutron star spins at an enormous speed. The fastest neutron star ever recorded spins around 700 times a second. We know it's turning this quickly because it's blasting out beams of radiation that sweep past us like an insane lighthouse. This, of course, is a pulsar, and we did a whole episode on them. A regular star would be torn apart, but neutron stars have such intense gravity they can rotate this quickly. Over time, the radiation streaming from the neutron star strips away its angular momentum and it slows down. Black holes can spin even faster than that. In fact, when a black hole is actively feeding from a binary companion or a supermassive black hole is gobbling up stars, it can rotate at nearly the speed of light. The laws of physics prevent anything in the universe spinning faster than the speed of light, and black holes go right up to the edge of the law without breaking it. Astronomers recently found a supermassive black hole spinning up to 87% the maximum speed permitted by relativity. So there you go. Now you know how fast stars and dead stars can spin. What other mysteries in astronomy and physics fascinate you? Let me know your suggestions for future episodes. In our next episode, we wonder what the universe does when we're not looking. Oh, and make sure you stick around for the blooper. Is this the part where your brain shuts off and you start looking around for new videos to watch and I'm always going blah, blah, Patreon this, blah, blah, community that? Wait a second. And seriously consider, if you're getting value from all these space videos, articles, podcasts we're making, for as little as a dollar a month, you can support us directly. In exchange, we'll remove all the advertising from Universe Today and even invite you into our inner circle community of members who support us in making great space and astronomy content. As of right now, there are 530 amazing supporters directly funding the work that we do on Universe Today. They get to see our videos in advance, hang out with me and the team, and see unreleased material, and they never see an ad on Universe Today. And we'd like to thank Adit Abrason, Nick Torelli, David Skipper, and the rest of the members who support us in making great space astronomy content. Want to get in the action? Go to patreon.com/universetoday. Oh no, the Dapple Police.
It's like, no, Jay will come back.
Yeah, he's like, you guys screwed it up.
Well, I mean, that's the best outcome. He comes back.
Yeah, that'd be good.